أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم and good morning everyone. Let's start our lecture. If you remember, we started inventory management last week and in the first lecture, I hope everyone can see the screen.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Okay, thank
you. Yes, sir, bilkul theek hai.
Okay. So last week we started with the basics of inventory management. The purpose of having the inventory, I mean, there are various objectives of keeping the stocks. For example, it provides a selection to the customers. I mean, customers can select any product if it is available in the stock. Sometimes there is inflation and the prices go high. So due to quantity discounts, the producers are the products provider, they keep the stocks. So that is another reason, and so I mean there are a number of reasons due to which we keep the inventory. Although we know that keeping the inventory is basically tying up your money in the inventory, but still we keep the inventory. There are two main questions regarding the inventory which needs to be answered. Those questions need to be answered, like how much to order and when to order. And when we look at the inventory, so we find it in four various ways, like raw material in the form of in the form of work in process, then in the form of spare parts, in the form of finished goods. So these are the various forms of inventory. Then there are certain costs which are associated with the inventory, like the ordering cost or the setup cost, when we place an order, so obviously we call it an ordering cost. When we set up the machines in order to produce it, so we call it setup cost. Both are same thing. And then holding cost or carrying cost, that's another cost. And then the sometimes we face the shortages of the inventory, so there's a shortage cost as well. In addition to the inventory cost itself, so these are various costs which needs reduced, and then we classify the inventory using the ABC classification. A class includes the inventory which is 20% by number or by volume, you can say, but it's quite high regarding the regarding money wise. So around 80% of the revenue is tied up with the 20% of the inventory. So we group that into A class. Then we have B class. B class further aids 30%. And regarding value-wise, it is 15%. And the rest of the 50%, it is around 5% value-wise. So that's how we classify the inventory into A, B, and C class. Then there are various models available, like the economic order quantity model, the production models, and last time in our previous lecture, we basically proved that how do we find the economic order quantity, or how do we derive the economic order quantity model. Okay, today is the second part of the same topic. there are various situations, and the person who is responsible for managing the inventory, he can face various situations, and according to the situation, they can come up with the solution to the inventory problems. So here we have there are a number of models available. The first one, like static deterministic inventory models. So static deterministic inventory models, it means that the demand is deterministic, or that is known in advance, and the demand rate over the period of time, that is also same. So that is static deterministic model. Then we have dynamic deterministic inventory model. So in the dynamic and deterministic model, the demand for each period is known and constant, but the demand rate varies from period to period. That changes, so we call that a dynamic deterministic inventory model. Then we have static probabilistic inventory models. So in static probabilistic, the demand is basically random, and the probability distribution of demand, that is same for every period or for each period. And then in the dynamic probabilistic inventory models, the demand varies as well as the probability distribution of the demand changes from period to period. So these are various situations, and accordingly one can find the economic order quantity, the optimum quantity for the lot size, or one can come up with the proper inventory model. Okay. Okay, so we are going through the first one, which is the static deterministic inventory models. Here we are using certain notations which are used in this model. C is used for the purchase price per unit if purchased, right? And R, unit variable cost of production if produced. But anyway, C is the purchase price. D is the demand rate, and that is units per year. A is the ordering cost or the setup cost. P is the production or replenishment rate. And usually P is more than the demand rate. right? So P is greater than the demand, right? Otherwise, you won't be able to replenish your inventory. H is the inventory carrying cost or holding cost. And sometimes we write this as H is equal to IC, where I is the interest rate, annual interest rate, and C is the unit cost. I subscript maximum is the maximum on hand inventory. So I max, I bar is the average on hand inventory. Similarly, S max, subscript maximum, that is maximum shortage permitted. And only S, that is the average shortage.
Sir, what is the purpose of all these four models? I mean, why do we study these four models?
Because there are different situations, like the first one, which is the static deterministic model. The assumption is that the demand is known, that is constant, and the demand over the period of time, or from period to period, that is also the same. So that is one situation. Similarly, when you have the probability when the demand is uncertain, so you cannot use those models in the uncertainty kind of situation. So that's why there are different models, right? So models, as I said, I mean, there are sometimes the things are quite predictable, they are known, so you can use one kind of model. But if, when the things change with the period of time, over the period of time, or I mean, the demand is uncertain. So the model which you, one of the models, for example, in the like the economic order quantity model, that is no more valid in such kind of situations. So that's why you need another kind of model. But over here, you need to know, or you need to understand the basics of developing the model. So once you know that, according to the situation, you can come up with a solution. So that is the objective.
Okay,
so these are the notations which are used. Further, we have like R, we use that R as for the reorder level, Q for the order quantity, pi is the shortage cost per unit short, which is independent of the duration of the shortage. Usually we call that fixed shortage cost. And pi hat, that is the shortage cost per unit short per year. And we call this variable shortage cost. So simply pi is the fixed shortage cost and pi hat is the variable shortage cost, because it changes our, this is basically per year. Okay, then capital T, that is the cycle length, the length of the time between production runs, when you place an order, when you receive. So simply that, cycle length. TC is the total annual cost. Total annual cost, which is a function of the inventory policy. And L is the lead time, which is the length of time between placement and receipt. Okay, now this is the single product model.
Sir, I have a question, sir. Sir, yes. What is the difference between a lead time and a cycle time?
Okay. This is the basically cycle time and lead time. I mean, sometimes people confuse them with one another, right? Lead time is basically when you place an order and when you receive it. When you place an order and when you receive, that is the lead time. In between, you might be having certain like waiting times, move time. If you remember the complete cycle of from input to the output of an inventory. So you sometimes inspect the coming inventory, then you, that is issued, that is queued somewhere before the machine, and then its own process time, and then it goes out. So we call that basically lead time. Cycle time is when a part is waiting for a machine, because another part is already there in the machine, and once that is completed, you basically load it. So that is the cycle time. So you can see, in both, basically it's regarding the part, but one is waiting for its turn to be processed on the machine, right? And the other one is basically like placing an order till its replenishment. like length between placement and receipt of orders. Sorry, it is receipt of orders, placement an order and receipt of order. So once you place an order, it goes to the suppliers, right? The suppliers then check whether he has the inventory or not. Once that inventory is, he collects the required inventory, which is required by someone, right? So then he sends that shipment to that organization. Once that is received, so the time elapsed between these two is basically the lead time. Okay, this is the single product model. Now, on the y-axis, we have the inventory level, right? This is the inventory level. And on the x-axis, we have time. This is time. Okay. This line, I think you are aware of it. This line is basically replenishment, and this one is depletion. Depletion means when the inventory is used. Now here, we are considering the shortages as well. Because once the inventory is at its maximum, jo bhi yahan par hai, for example, this point, here it shows the maximum inventory, which you can store, right? So once it is at its maximum, and after that it is used up, so obviously it reduces, it depletes. When it depletes, so obviously it goes to, in the economic order quantity model, if you remember, there is a reorder point, and then when it touches this line, it is replenished straight away, like it goes up instantaneously, but in reality is different, okay? So here, the shortages are also allowed. How do we have the shortages? The shortages are, for example, there are orders from the customers and you don't have inventory to fulfill those orders. So obviously you go into negative, we call that shortages. So there is a limit on the shortages as well, like max, how much you can allow, the maximum shortage which you can allow. So looking at your capacity, your resources, you can say that we can allow so much of shortages. After this, we won't entertain the orders. So that's why the maximum shortages. And then after this, the inventory is replenished. Then how is it replenished? Either you place an order to the supplier to replenish the inventory, or you produce the inventory. So when P is more than D, this slope shows P minus D. This slope is P minus D because production is more than the demand rate, while here it is only consumed. This slope shows D. And if you look at this notation, D is basically the demand rate and P is the production. So this is depletion, this is replenishment. Here we have this point, this T, this is basically the cycle length. Okay, the inventory, when it crosses this timeline and it goes into negative or into shortages, so there is a maximum limit on the shortage which the organization can allow. We call that maximum shortage. So S maximum, and here the maximum inventory which you can store, right? So I maximum. Okay, at point A, we start producing, or the organization starts producing, and then inventory builds up, right? Inventory builds up, and then it goes to the maximum point. From M to J, from at point A, we start producing. From M to J, we first fulfill the back orders. What is back orders? The orders which are already due, which you need to fulfill first, right? So the back orders are met first, and then we go into positive because we are crossing this line, and then we reach to the maximum, which is point K. Okay, so we have built up inventory over here. After this, the inventory is used up. Slope D, right? It is used up because we are meeting the customers are basically, you can say, like, are they purchasing? We are fulfilling their demand. We are meeting their requests. So we exhaust that inventory, and at this point, L again, then it goes into the shortages, and then it goes up. So this is the single product model considering the shortages. Considering these shortages. Once we develop a model from this, then we can take various assumptions from there, and we can come up with a number of different models from this one, from this single product model. Okay, further explaining from this T1. T1 is basically the time during which we are meeting the back orders, time T1. T2, we are in positive and we are carrying now the inventory. We are carrying the inventory over here. T3, again, we are carrying the inventory. T4 is the time period where we have the shortages. And this capital T is the total cycle length. Okay, there are two variables. Two decision variables. Here we have two decision variables. What should be the optimum quantity, which is Q star? If you remember, in the economic order quantity model, we basically calculated Q star. What was Q star equal to? Q star was equal to square root of 2AD divided by H. That was the formula. Sometimes we denote the ordering cost or the setup, the querying cost with different notations. So, but anyway, the main equation is 2AD, where A is the setup cost, D is demand, and H is the querying cost. So that was the, in that equation, in that model, there was no shortage, right? There was no shortage, and there were some other assumptions, like the inventory is replenished instantaneously. When we say instantaneously, then it means it goes straight up from here to this point, and then it comes down, then it goes up, and like that. So that was another kind of model. Here we are considering the shortages. So our two decision variables are: what should be the optimum quantity of inventory, so Q star, and another one is the S maximum, how much should be the maximum shortage. Okay. Here now, we have developed some equations. By the way, I have taken these equations, I mean this material, from the book of Al-Sayyid. I'll give you the scanned images of this particular topic. I have this book with me. I don't think this is available anymore. It's out of stock nowadays. This is Analysis and Control of Production Systems by Al-Sayyid and Boucher. So the time to produce a lot, Q, that is equal to TP, time to produce, and that is equal to Q over P. Now Q is the quantity and P is the production rate. Q is in units and P is units per unit time. So units are canceled, you only get time. So times to produce, TP, okay? Maximum inventory level, IMAX, that is equal to time to produce times P minus D. P minus D is basically that slope in which we accumulate the inventory, minus S max. Go back and see this slope. And this is the S max. So time to produce, I mean, this is the time we are producing from here to here. Time to produce, and then times P minus D minus S max. This equation can be written in this form as well, like I max is equal to Q, simply by rearranging the things, Q into 1 minus D over P minus S max. Now the total cost equation. Now the total cost equation I mean, we have to develop a total cost equation, and you will see now in a minute that how that that equation is developed. The total cost equation in basically includes the setup cost, the carrying cost, the shortages cost, and even the cost of the the price of the inventory itself, or the cost of the inventory itself. So these are various components of cost. And we need to find those various components first, and then we will develop the total cost equation. Okay, so one component of the cost is basically the ordering cost or the setup cost. Okay, that is one thing. A second component of the every cycle cost is the cost of carrying the inventory. Simply mean like the carrying cost, setup cost. Then the other one is the carrying cost. Now, where do we carry the, when do we carry the inventory? If you look at this model, here we are meeting the back orders from M to J. We are meeting the back orders. Okay. Once the inventory is in positive, and then it goes to the maximum point, it means we are carrying inventory over here and also from K to L, this point. So the times are T2 and T3. During T2 and T3, we basically carry the inventory. Okay. So T2, let's find T2. T2 is equal to I max divided by P minus D. T3, I max over D. Go back to that figure and you will see. T2 is equal to I max over P minus D, and T3 is I max over D. Time to build the inventory from zero to IMAX, and time to consume the amount of inventory from IMAX to zero. These are the times. Now the average inventory I bar over the cycle T. Remember average inventory I bar over the cycle T is the area of the triangle JKL. JKL. अब यहां पे जो एवरेज इन्वेंट्री है वो दैट इज इक्वल टू आई बार इज इक्वल टू 1/2t. दिस इज बेसिकली आई मैक्स ओवर टी, सो दैट विल गिव यू द एवरेज इन्वेंट्री ओवर द साइकिल. सो दैट ओवर द साइकिल मींस डिवाइड बाय टी एज वेल. सो वी कैन राइट इट 1/2t इनटू t2 plus t3, and obviously when we write it this in this equation in this form, then obviously IMAX is multiplied. So that will be the average inventory. Now you can put the value of T2 and T3. We know T2 and T3 equal to, and from there, and similarly this T is equal to Q over D. Cycle, right? It's a cycle. So how many cycles will be required? For example, you come up with your quantity Q. When you divide quantity with the annual demand, you can find the number of cycles, right? A number of cycles, cycle hai kya, basically after, placing the orders, like when should you place the order? Right? When should you place the order? So obviously it is calculated in days, because Q is the unit. I mean, from here Q is shown in units, D is in units per unit time, and that per unit time is per year. If you go back and look at the definition of D, that is annual demand. Annual demand means units per year. So obviously you will get this time in years. We can convert that into days. For example, you come up with 20 days. It means after each 20 days, you need to place an order. So that will be the cycle. Okay, so we can calculate T as Q over D. So we have replaced that capital T, which was here, with Q over D. Similarly, T2 with IMAX divided by P minus D, and T3 with the IMAX over D. Multiply by IMAX. So when we insert these, or when we substitute these, we get I bar as this equation, which is 3.4. q into 1 minus d over p minus s max whole square divided by 2q into 1 minus d over p. The average carrying cost over the cycle t is, this is the average inventory. Now the average carrying cost, average carrying cost, obviously it needs average inventory. So average inventory is here, h is here, because there is, this h is the inventory carrying cost, right? Per year, or per period, you can say, times cycle, the cycle time, or t. So the average carrying cost over a cycle t is h capital T times I bar. That is another component of the cost. The first component, if you remember, that was the ordering cost. And the ordering cost is denoted by a symbol A. And that is shown in the notations as well. So A, that was one component. Now, if we add the second component, the carrying cost, that will be ht I bar. But in between, you know, what is this I bar equal to? The third component of the inventory cost is the shortage cost, which occurs over the time T1 and T4. Go back and see, here we have these shortages. T1 is this period, so we are having shortage. T4 from L to N, again, we are facing shortage. So these are the two time periods during which there is a shortage. And this one. Now T1, time to eliminate the back orders, right? Time to eliminate the back orders, because first you need to meet the back orders, and then after that you need to develop the inventory. So T1 is equal to S max or P minus T, and T4, another time period in which we have this, we face a shortage. So time to build a back order of S max. T4 is equal to S max over D. Now we have T1, T4. And if you remember, there are two components of the shortage cost. One is the fixed shortage cost, which is denoted by pi, and the other one is the pi hat. Pi hat is the variable shortage cost. Now the average shortage cost, is 1 over 2t, or you can write it 1 over t times S max square divided by 2d into 1 minus d over p equal to this thing, because these values are basically inserted. Before this equation, like we had an equation for the average inventory, that was, if you remember, here, let me go back, this one. I bar is equal to 1 over 2t into t2 plus t3 into I max. For s, we can write s is equal to 1 over 2t into t1 plus t4. Because in t1, we basically meet the back orders, or we eliminate the back orders. And in t4, we build the back orders to s max. So we can write 1 over 2t into t1 plus t4 into S max, because that is related with shortage. And after that, you can write this equation simply by inserting the values of T1 and T4. And also replacing T with Q over D. So you can get this equation. S max square divided by 2Q into 1 minus D over P. And the average shortage cost during the cycle T is, this one is the variable shortage cost over the cycle. This one is the fixed shortage cost. Pi into S max is a fixed shortage cost, while this one is the variable shortage cost, which varies with the cycle. The average cost per cycle is the sum of the ordering cost. Now we are going for all the cost components. The average cost per cycle is the sum of the ordering cost, so this is ordering cost, plus item cost, because this is unit purchase price and this is Q, number of units. So simply multiply that, you will get the unit cost or the item cost plus the average carrying cost plus the variable shortage cost plus the fixed shortage cost. So these two are basically shortage costs. This one, average carrying cost, item cost, setup cost. So that is the total cost. And we can write, let me take my T as well with this. Okay. The total annual cost is obtained by multiplying equation 3.6, that previous equation, this one, by the number of orders per year. Now, number of orders, simply number of orders, you can get the number of orders because D is the annual demand. And if you come up with a lot size Q, so when you divide that total, that annual demand with the lot size, you will get the number of orders. कि आपको इतने orders चाहिए, right? उन orders के बीच में time क्या हो? इसको उल्टा दें, इसको Q by D कर दें. So you will get the time between the orders, which was T. And also substituting H as IC, क्योंकि हम जो holding cost है, our carrying cost है, we can write that as IC. Where I is the interest rate and C is the unit price. We obtain the total cost equation. ये वही cost है. अब इसको अगर हम D by Q से multiply कर दें, इसको भी D by Q से, मतलब पूरी equation को D by Q से आप multiply कर दें. और H को replace कर दें IC से. So we get this equation. ये वाली equation हमारे पास आ जाती है. Now in the total cost, as I said earlier on, that we have two decision variables. One is Q, कि आपका जो Q है वो optimum क्या हो, और जो S max है वो क्या हो आपकी. So these are the two decision variables. Okay, substitute for I bar and S, क्योंकि इसमें I bar भी आ रहा है, इसमें S भी आ रहा है, और हमने अभी इनको calculate किया है here. I bar was this thing equal to, I bar was equal to, I mean this equation, or this is the equation for I bar, and S for S, we have this equation 3.5. So, unko aap yahan par is equation mein, jo 3.7 hai, is pe aap insert kar de. So, we get this equation 3.8, TC, total cost of Q and S with these two variables, Q and S max, AD by Q plus CD and so on. This is equation 3.8. Now, this is the major equation. This is the major equation. Now, if someone asked me that, why do we have so many different models, right? And obviously those models were, some of the models are related to the deterministic situation, some are to the probabilistic situation, and with different conditions. There are four various conditions, right? We have now taken up only one model, and that is static deterministic. And within static deterministic, we have developed this major equation, this one, this equation. Now, if you take various assumptions only within this equation, you can come up with a number of models. अगर आप कहते हैं कि नहीं, we are not permitting the shortages, so simply wherever there are shortages that will be taken out, or shortages का जो cost है, pi है या pi hat है या pi, वो सारे खत्म हो जाएंगे. So you will, this equation will be reduced to one form, that is one model. Or if you simply assume that you have only the variable shortage cost, you don't have the fixed shortage cost, so aapki equation alag ho jayegi. And see, so this is one major equation from where we can develop a number of models for Q and S max. Now the decision variables of this model, do decision variable the maine aapko bataya tha, are Q and S max. and their optimum values can be obtained by solving the following simultaneous equations. Yeah. Now, we first solve this equation for Q, right? पहले आप इसको Q के लिए करें वो करें और दोबारा इसको फिर आप यू मीन्स आई मीन डिफरेंशिएट दिस इक्वेशन फर्स्ट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू क्यू एंड देन द सेम इक्वेशन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एस मैक्स दोनों को साइमल्टेनियसली एंड इक्वेट देम इक्वल टू जीरो वंस दिस इज डन देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स इन्वॉल्वड इन बिटवीन बिकॉज You need to go through the differentiation process of this equation. First, differentiate this with respect to Q and then make it equal to zero and then differentiate the same equation with respect to S max and then make it equal to zero. So then we get Q star and S max star. अगर हमने इनको differentiate कर लिया तो उसके बाद Q star जो है उसकी ये form बनती है. So this is another model, Q star. Which is equation 3.11 और S max जो आपके पास आएगा वो ये होगी equation 3.12 then we have some special cases क्या है one of the most common inventory models occurs when the production rate P is infinite When P is infinite होता है कोई normally finite होते हैं but if it is a production process which is repeating itself continuously then we can assume that it is infinite anyway simply consider that P is infinite and shortages are not allowed so हम ये यू लिख सकते हैं ना कि P is infinity and S max is zero In equation 3.8 वो main equation है जो हमने अभी बनाई थी ये वाली equation इस equation में S max को zero ले लें जिस तरह इन्होंने कहा assume कर लें कि S max zero है और P जो है आपका infinity है जब P infinity होगी तो ज़ाहिर बात है ये term zero हो जाएगी क्योंकि ये term एक बहुत बड़ी term से आप इसको divide कर रहे हैं तो ये zero हो जाएगी S max zero हो जाएगा यहाँ पे pi है ये pi hat है ये सारे zero हो जाएंगे So the equation reduces to total cost of Q is equal to AD over Q plus CD plus IC over IC times Q by 2. Now, if we differentiate this equation with respect to Q, so we end up with Q star and Q star is equal to square root of 2AD over IC. Now, ye kya cheez hai? Square root of 2AD over IC. This is economic order quantity model, जो कि हमने last lecture में पढ़ा था हमने तो direct इसको ले लिया था लेकिन इसको लेने के लिए ज़रा बात है आपको आप हमने अभी जो model develop किया है वो बड़ा versatile model है उसमें आप मुख्तलिफ assumptions ले सकते हैं So you can come up with this model. और अगर आप कोई और assumption ले लें तो आपको कोई और model बन जाता है According to the situation, अगर ये situation है तो क्या होगा Accordingly, you can come up with the model. So Q star using differentiating this equation with these conditions where we assume that P is infinite and S max is zero. We calculate Q star and that is square root of 2AD over IC. हमारे जो पिछली equation थी जो हमने derive की थी उसमें क्या था? Square root of 2AD divided by H, लेकिन H को रिप्लेस किया गया है IC से आप लिख सकते हैं इसको IC. Okay, equation 3.14 is referred to as the economic order quantity model. If the shortage cost per unit short is zero, the shortage cost per unit short is zero. Pi it means the fixed variable, the fixed shortage cost. Pi is zero. अगर सिर्फ ये हो तो अभी जो इक्वेशन थी ये इक्वेशन 3.11 और 3.12 जो थी ये वाली इक्वेशंस 3.11 एंड 3.12 इसमें अगर सिर्फ पाई जीरो हो ये वाली तो ये फिर क्या होगी इक्वेशन आपकी then this will be the equations. Another model, and model for the maximum shortage which you can allow. अगर आप इनको substitute कर लें total cost equation में, total cost equation for Q and S max वो ये बन जाती है फिर आपकी 3.17. Another special case occurs when both pi and pi hat are finite, while the production rate P is infinite. आप shortages तो consider करें, लेकिन P जो है वो infinite है. तो उसी total cost equation में पहले इसको लिखें, उसके बाद differentiate करें, तो आपको जो Q star मिलेगा वो ये होगी. This will be the optimum quantity for the for inventory, and this will be the maximum shortage which you can allow. 3.19 and 3.20 equations. The optimal value for Q star is reduced to 3.21 when shortages are not allowed. अगर इसमें shortages भी आप allow नहीं करते, तो आपकी ये equation बन जाती है, and this is the production quantity model जो है. एक तो economic order quantity model था, एक था production model. So this is the production model then. Okay. Now let's go through an example. A company XYZ purchases air filters that are used at the rate of 350 per year. The cost of each filter is $30. ये cost है. So what is this C? This is basically okay. Let me go first here. Purchases air filters that are used at the rate of 350. ये 350 क्या है? This is demand. So D. Okay. The cost of each filter is $30. So this is C. And the cost of placing each order is $10. So this is ordering cost. A. Right? That is $10. The inventory carrying cost rate is not the cost, it's the cost rate is 0.18. It means I. Shortage cost consists of two components, fixed cost of $0.3 per unit and variable cost of $5. So this is pi and this is pi hat. Find both the optimal order quantity and the optimal shortage. When these are the conditions, the company XYZ purchases air filters that are used at the rate of this per year. It means that company is every year they are purchasing. Right, every year they are purchasing. So we can say, since the company purchases the air filters which are delivered in a batch, it is assumed that P is infinity. जो produce कर रही है जिसको उसकी जो production हो रही है उसकी air filters की, so वो हम उसको infinite assume करते हैं. When we consider P is as infinity. While considering the other parameters, we are allowing the shortages because we have considered the fixed cost and the fixed cost for the shortage and the variable cost for the shortage. It means we are considering the shortages. So we end up with one kind of model, and that is the same. That is this model, जो कि हमने 3.1 equation में वहाँ पे लिखा था इसको 3.19 में. So that equation is used. So accordingly, we calculate, and this is the optimal quantity, 47.83. We round it to 48 units per year, and similarly the S max that is equal to 15 units. ये वही equations हैं, ये वाली equations, ये 3.19 and 3.20. क्योंकि ये कंडीशंस वहां पे एग्जिस्ट कर रही थी व्हेन पी इज इनफिनिटी और बाकी चीजें आपकी हो. सो ये आपका ऑप्टिमल क्वांटिटी है. अब यहाँ पर आपका इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी मॉडल तो नहीं चलता क्योंकि इसमें यहाँ पर वो है शॉर्टेजेस हैं, तो शॉर्टेजेस को वो मॉडल कैटर नहीं करता. सिमिलरली जो प्रोडक्शन मॉडल है वो भी शॉर्टेजेस को काउंटर कैटर नहीं करता. तो अगर शॉर्टेजेस हैं तो फिर देन यू नीड अनदर काइंड ऑफ मॉडल व्हिच आर प्रेजेंटेड हियर. ये सो क्यू स्टार एंड एस मैक्स. Now the cycle length क्या होगी? Cycle length is Q by D. That is in years, because this is units. This is units per year. So you get this in years. This is 48 by demand, and demand is 350. So 48 by 350, that is 0.137 years. Isko hum days mein convert kar sakte hain, because in a year there are 365 days. So it is equal to 50 days. जो साइकिल लेंथ होगी वो 50 डेज होगी, मतलब 50 दिन बाद आपको फिर आपका एक और साइकिल चलेगा. द एनुअल, और उसकी एनुअल कॉस्ट क्या होगी, उस एनुअल कॉस्ट की इक्वेशन भी यहाँ पे बता दी उन्होंने. सिर्फ इसमें पी नहीं है, क्योंकि पी इनफाइनाइट बन जाएगा, तो आपकी वो जो पहली वाली इक्वेशन 3.8 वो 3.22 की फॉर्म ले लेगी. ये अगर हमने किया है 3.22, सो दैट विल बी द टोटल कॉस्ट, like 10,679. Then we have another example. I leave this example to you because it is already solved. There is no need to go through it. Now, sensitivity analysis. Sensitivity analysis is carried out in order to verify that the model which is developed is working, I mean, perfectly, or that model is valid. So remember, whenever you develop any model, zaruri nahi ki ye model ho, ye hamare ye inventory ka model ho, koi dusra model ho, to usko ये बताने के लिए कि जो मॉडल आपने डेवलप किया ये ठीक है, यू नीड टू वेरीफाई एंड वैलिडेट दैट. सो सेंसिटिविटी एनालिसिस इज वन ऑफ द टेक्निक्स व्हिच इज यूज्ड टू वेरीफाई एंड वैलिडेट योर मॉडल्स व्हिच यू हैव डेवलप्ड. इन दिस केस द मॉडल व्हिच वाज डेवलप्ड, दैट इज बेसिकली द इन्वेंट्री मॉडल, एंड let's go through it. Suppose that in example 3.1, abhi humne jo example ki abhi air filters ki, the actual cost of processing an order was $20. Usme cost, I remember the cost was $10, lekin unhone kaha ki chalo hum ye assume kar lete hain ki uski actual cost jo thi wo $20 thi, lekin humne galti kar di, 100% galti kar di, humne $10 le li usko. That we had erroneously estimated it as $10. Therefore, the true Q star and S max star should have been, ये होने चाहिए थे. आपने अभी जो मॉडल हमने यूज किया उसकी सेंसिटिविटी एनालिसिस हम कर रहे हैं, हम कह रहे हैं कि उस एग्जाम्पल में उन्होंने वही एग्जाम्पल पिक किया और उसकी सेंसिटिविटी एनालिसिस कर रहे हैं मॉडल की, कि क्या ये मॉडल ठीक है भी कि नहीं. तो ये बता दिया कि हमने इतनी बड़ी गलती कर दी कि हम 100% गलत चले गए, क्योंकि हमने 20 उसके एक्चुअल जो ऑर्डर था वो $20 का होना चाहिए था, हमने $10 ले लिया, और $20 के मुताबिक जो क्वांटिटीज कैलकुलेट होनी थी वो ये थी जो कि एक्चुअल होनी थी, 71 यूनिट्स, और जो शॉर्टेज है 27 यूनिट्स की. आप जाए पीछे जरा देखें, उसमें हमने जो अभी कैलकुलेट किया है इस एग्जाम्पल में 48 यूनिट्स हमने कैलकुलेट किए अकॉर्डिंग टू $10, 48 यूनिट्स और 15 यूनिट्स. लेकिन वो कह रहे हैं कि से आपने ये गलती की थी और एक्चुअल वैल्यूज जो उसकी थी वो $20 थी, जिसके मुताबिक क्यू स्टार ने कैलकुलेट होना था 71 एंड 27 यूनिट्स. और इसी तरह टोटल कॉस्ट जो है, एंड द टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रेटजी एक्सक्लूडिंग द सीडी टर्म दैट शुड हैव बीन adopted is. अच्छा, CD term को इन्होंने इसलिए बीच में से exclude किए था कि इनकी calculation थोड़ी simplify हो जाए, इनको कम effort लगे, क्योंकि इस चीज से CD पे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ने वाला, क्योंकि C एक unit price है और D एक annual demand है. तो अगर आप इसमें add करते हैं उसमें add करते हैं, दोनों same terms होंगी, दोनों same amount होंगी. फर्क जो पड़ना है वो holding cost पे और setup cost पे और shortage वगैरह पे फर्क पड़ना है, जो इसलिए उन्होंने इसको एक्सक्लूड कर दिया. नाउ टीसी अकॉर्डिंग टू द टोटल कॉस्ट इक्वेशन इज कैलकुलेटेड एज $248. हाउएवर, The total cost of the strategy excluding CD term that was actually adopted is ye 179. Jo pichli example thi usme agar aap CD term nikal den to aapke paas baki piche reh jata hai $179. Humne jo hum keh rahe ki humne galti ki aur galti ke mutabik actual cheeze ye aani thi to cost bhi ye aani thi 245. Okay, पिछले में एक्सक्लूडिंग सीडी टर्म ये आ रही थी $179. उसके मुताबिक जो परसेंटेज में एरर आ रहा है, देयरफॉर विद 100% एरर इन एस्टिमेटिंग द ऑर्डरिंग ऑर्डर कॉस्ट, द एक्चुअल टोटल कॉस्ट इज हायर बाय 248 माइनस 179 डिवाइडेड बाय 178. आपने गलती की 100%, लेकिन आपका मॉडल जो है फिर भी आपको जो 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 एक्चुअल कॉस्ट है उसमें वो 100% नहीं शो करा, वो दैट इज 38.5% बता रहा है. इट मींस दिस इज अ रोबस्ट मॉडल. रोबस्ट कि अगर आप गलती कर भी दें तो जो इसका आउटपुट है इस मॉडल पे उस पर इतना फर्क नहीं पड़ता. हालांकि आपने आप 100% गलती पे चले गए थे और 100% गलती कोई नहीं करता. तो अगर आप कम गलती करेंगे तो बात है, तो मॉडल आपका फिर भी आपको करेक्ट आंसर देगा. दैट्स व्हाई वी डू द सेंसिटिविटी एनालिसिस. अगर ये भी बहुत ज्यादा फर्क होता तो हम कहते यस द मॉडल इज नॉट रोबस्ट. ये तो भैया गलती पे गलती को उसी तरह मतलब शो करे और भी बढ़ा रहा है इस चीज को, तो ये रोबस्ट ना होता और इसकी एक्सेप्टेबिलिटी मॉडल की फिर ना होती. ओके, द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज क्वांटिटी डिस्काउंट मॉडल्स. सो फार वी हैव कंसिडर्ड अ फिक्स्ड प्राइस पर यूनिट रिगार्डलेस ऑफ द साइज ऑफ द ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी. ओप्स, मैं आपको बता दूं सिंपली इन क्वांटिटी डिस्काउंट. For example, if you purchase one item, so there is the unit cost or unit purchase price. But if you purchase the same item in bulk, so usually discounts are given. That is the same thing which is applied here. For example, the order size lies between 0 and Q1. Obviously 0 is not possible, 0 is less than, so it starts with 1 and Q1 ki koi quantity hai. So 1 is less than Q, or 0 is less than Q, and that is less than Q1. So this will be the unit variable cost. If the quantity is between Q1 variable cost, and similarly Q2 is less than equal to Q, that is less than Q3, C3, and Q3 is less than equal to Q, then C4. So aapko ek list hai aapke paas ki agar ye quantities hain to bhai unit price fir ye hogi. Log fir dekhte hain ki bhai hum unke liye feasible kya hai. So here we have the proper way of doing it ki aapke liye feasible ya feasible quantities kya honi chahiye based on these. Here we develop the total cost equation, and the total cost equation includes the setup cost, unit cost, I mean items cost, and the average carrying cost. Okay, two steps hamare paas, wo ye hain ke hum isko kaise determine karte hain. Determine the economic order quantity Q star. इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी, व्हेन वी से इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी आपके ज़हन में फौरन आ जाना चाहिए, Q star is equal to square root of 280 divided by H. Determine the economic order quantity based on least price. आप least price से शुरू करें, C4 से. If Q star is less than Q3, जो Q star है वो Q3 से कम है, then make Q star equal to Q3, क्योंकि Q3 तक तो आप जा सकते हैं. Equals Q3, the total cost The total cost TC at C4 is calculated by that equation and go to step two. If Q star is more than or equal to Q3, the Q star aapne calculate kiya, then Q star is optimal with the region C4. And the total cost is calculated by this equation. Step two, determine the economic order quantity. ये चीज़ हम अब जो next वो price range है उस पे apply करेंगे. We calculate Q star based on C3. If Q star is less than Q2, then Q2 is the optimal order quantity at C3. The total cost is calculated and go to the next step. If Q2 is less than Q star and that is less than equal to Q3, then Q star is optimal within the region C3. Evaluate the total cost TC at considering C3 and go to step three. If Q3 is less than equal to Q star, then Q3 is optimal within the region C3. और फिर आप टोटल कॉस्ट कैलकुलेट करें. इन स्टेप्स को आप रिपीट करते जाएं और आखिर यहां तक के वो सारे आप मालूम कर लें, C1 तक आप चले जाएं. उसके बाद फिर कंपेयर करें, कंपेयर टोटल कॉस्ट CI, वेयर I इज इक्वल टू 1, 2, 3, 4, क्योंकि यहां पर चार प्राइस रेंजेस हैं. ऑर्डर द क्वांटिटी Q करस्पॉन्डिंग टू द मिनिमम ऑफ TC एट CI. इसको एक्सप्लेन किया गया, एग्जाम्पल से आप इसको समझ लेंगे. यहां पर An operating telephone company purchases large quantities of semiconductors to be used in manufacturing electronic switching systems. Shortages are not allowed. जब shortages allowed नहीं है तो फौरन आपके जहन में आ जाना चाहिए कि भाई वो चीज तो गई, SMAX वाली या पाई हेड वाली बात तो गई. The demand rate is 250,000 units per year. This is D. And the order cost is $100 per order. The order cost is $100. This is A. The annual inventory carrying rate is 0.24. I and is based on the value of the average inventory. The supplier's price schedule is as follows. Agar to aapki quantities 5,000 se kam hai, तो आपको यूनिट कॉस्ट जो है $12 पे करना है. अगर आपकी क्वांटिटीज 5,000 इज लेस देन इक्वल टू क्यू, जो क्वांटिटी आप क्यू कैलकुलेट करेंगे लेकिन वो मैक्स वो कम है 20,000 से, तो फिर $11. इसी तरह $10 और $9 के लिए क्या है, 40,000 इज लेस देन इक्वल टू क्यू, देन $9. डिटरमिन हमें क्या करना है, ऑप्टिमल ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी. क्या हम अब हमारी ऑप्टिमल ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी क्या होनी चाहिए बेस्ड ऑन दिस प्राइस जो कि गिवन है. अस्यूम एन इनफाइनाइट रिप्लेनिशमेंट रेट AD ओवर Q J प्लस CJD plus I, CJ, QJ, 1, 2. इसमें चूंकि कुछ वैल्यूज हमें मालूम है, A is known, that is 100, इसमें चार मुख्तलिफ वैल्यूज है C की. So 250,000 CJ, we write this in this way, plus I जो है 0.24 है, CJ को उसी तरह छोड़ देते हैं, QJ हमें मालूम नहीं है, so divide by 2. Okay, so we get this equation. What if we differentiate this equation? This equation को हम differentiate करते हैं with respect to Q. With respect to Q, क्योंकि total cost of QJ हमें मालूम करनी है. So QJ star is equal to 10 to the power 3 square root of 25 divided by 0.12 CJ. ये equation हमारे पास आ जाती है. Now the only variable over here is CJ. If we consider J as 4, Q4 sa maloom karein, kyunki humne start karna kis se your least price pehle wahan se start karna hai. So this will be q star 4 aur phir c j kya hogi jo hogi aapko. So we start with the least price for j is equal to 4. C4 is $9. ये गिवन था इस इक्वेशन में. हम लीस्ट जो प्राइस है वहां से या कॉस्ट है वहां से यूनिट प्राइस वहां से स्टार्ट करते हैं. सो वी स्टार्ट विद दैट. इस इक्वेशन में C4 ले लें. सो दिस विल बी Q4 star 4. व्हेन वी कैलकुलेटेड दैट it came out 4,811, far less than 40,000. तो अगर हमें इस हमारी जो क्वांटिटी निकली, क्योंकि वो 40,000 तक जो है वो कह रहे कि अगर आप 40,000 तक जाएंगे तो आप हम आपकी यूनिट प्राइस ये होगी, तो हम क्यों ना बजाय हम उसको 4,800 लें, हम क्यों ना उसको 40,000 ले लें ताकि हमें वो यूनिट उसमें ज्यादा आइटम्स जो है वो मिल जाएं. सो वी मेक दैट इक्वल टू 40,000. क्यू स्टार वी मेक दैट इक्वल टू 40,000 एंड एट 40,000 देन वी कैलकुलेट द टोटल कॉस्ट. जिसकी कॉस्ट निकलती है ये, दिस इज द कॉस्ट. इसी तरह C3 When we consider C3 in that equation, इस equation में, तो ये Q3 आ जाएगा और यहाँ पर C3 की वैल्यू आप इंसर्ट करें तो आपके पास Q3 स्टार कैलकुलेट हो जाएगा, which is equal to 4,564, which is less than 20,000, क्योंकि यहाँ पर उन्होंने उसके दे दिए कि ये वाला 20,000 less than Q star and it is less than 40,000. So why don't you make it equal to 20,000? So we make it equal to 20,000 and then calculate the value, the total cost. Similarly, for C2, again it is less than 5,000. So we make this quantity equal to 5,000 and calculate the total cost. And last is the C1. So Q star, when that is calculated, it comes out 4,166, less than 50,000, and it is in the given range, क्योंकि given range भी यही था उसका. Q is less than 50,000. तो अभी हमने जो Q calculate किया वो है 4,166, that is less than 5,000. So we calculate the total cost using this value. जब इस value को आप calculate करते हैं तो हमारे पास जो total cost निकलती है वो ये वाली निकलती है. Now we compare. When we compare Q star, जो हमने quantities consider की 40,000, 20,000, 5,000 and this, and with these unit costs, and these were the total costs. So अब इसमें से जो minimum होगा, we have to go for that. अब minimum जो है वो इस unit price के साथ आ रहा है, C के साथ, और ये quantity आपको ज़्यादा quantity लेनी होगी. उसकी यूनिट कॉस्ट ये होगी, लेकिन आपकी टोटल कॉस्ट जो है वो कम होगी, वो बाकियों से कम है. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी देयरफॉर द ऑप्टिमल ऑर्डरिंग आवर क्वांटिटी इज 40,000 यूनिट्स एट अ टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ दिस मच.
सर मेरा एक क्वेश्चन है सर.
जी बोले
सर. ये पीछे एक स्ट्रिप सर आपने वो किया सर, वो किस तरह सर आपने वो डिफरेंशिएट किया सर, वो स्ट्रिप मुझे समझ नहीं आई सर.
ये इक्वेशन है.
यस सर.
ये इक्वेशन है आपके.
यस सर. ये स्ट्रिप
ये समझ नहीं आई सर. ये बेसिकली दिस इज डेल्टा टीसी और बीच में आपका क्यू है, क्योंकि आप क्यू पे इसको कैलकुलेट डिफरेंशिएट करें विद रिस्पेक्ट टू क्यू. तो अब बेसिकली आपने इस इक्वेशन को, ये जो है ना ये वाली, इस इक्वेशन को आप डिफरेंशिएट करें विद रिस्पेक्ट टू क्यू. जब आप इसको विद रिस्पेक्ट टू क्यू कैलकुलेट डिफरेंशिएट करेंगे एंड देन यू मेक इट इक्वल टू जीरो, सो यू गेट क्यू जे स्टार. क्यों ये? क्योंकि ये क्यू जे है, राइट? जब क्यू जी स्टार इसको करेंगे आप उसको रीअरेंज करें सो यू गेट दिस थिंग 10^3 और फिर ये स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 25 ये आप करें तो आपको ये पता चले ना इसको आप डिफ्रिशिएट करेंगे क्योंकि यहाँ पर मैंने वो स्टेप्स बीच में नहीं शो किए लेकिन बेसिकली यू दिस इक्वेशन इज डिफ्रिशिएटेड इट इज सिंपली डिफ्रिशिएशन इसको जब आप डिफ्रिशिएट करते हैं इस इक्वेशन को सो यू गेट दिस वैल्यू ये वाली चीज ठीक है
यस सर
हाँ इसको आप बैठे बेटा इसको आप बैठे इसको डिफ्रिशिएट कर लें तो आपको यू गेट द सेम थिंग यही चीज आपको मिलेगी ओके देन वी हैव द मल्टी आइटम इन्वेंट्री सिस्टम नाउ मल्टी आइटम जो अभी हमने कंसीडर किया था दैट वाज सिंगल प्रोडक्ट मॉडल सिंगल प्रोडक्ट मॉडल और उसकी हमने बाकी चीजें कैलकुलेट की हैं बट इन रियालिटी the organizations they deal with multiple items and those items are I mean different from one another the we can also use the single model and we can calculate those various those key costs वगैरह वो हम calculate कर सकते हैं but obviously that will be very tedious and especially the things get complicated when we have certain constraints किस किस्म की हो सकती हैं constraints हो सकती हैं कि भाई इतने यूनिट तो हैं लेकिन क्या इतने यूनिट के लिए आपके पास बजट भी है आपके पास इतने पैसे हैं क्या आप इतने यूनिट्स ले रहे हैं दूसरा constraint ये हो सकता है कि do you have enough space in order to store the inventory so या वो प्रोडक्ट अवेलेबल है भी या नहीं मार्केट में सो देयर आर अ नंबर ऑफ कंस्ट्रेंट्स हियर वी ट्राई टू फाइंड द मल्टीपल इन्वेंट्री मॉडल विथ सम कंस्ट्रेंट्स जिसके कंस्ट्रेंट्स भी हो और उन कंस्ट्रेंट्स को कंसीडर करते हुए हम फिर उनकी जो है टोटल कॉस्ट या मतलब हम वो कैलकुलेट करें ओके सो The total cost, अगर आपको याद हो उसमें क्या था कि हमने Q और S max को लिया था लेकिन चूंकि यहाँ पर हम मल्टीपल आइटम्स की बात कर रहे हैं तो उसमें हम कहेंगे कि टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ Q1, Q2, इट कैन गो अप टू Qn, मुख्तलिफ आपके पास मल्टीपल आइटम्स हैं और उनकी टोटल कॉस्ट तो ऑब्वियसली ये वाला पार्ट ये पहले एक मॉडल के लिए था या एक प्रोडक्ट के लिए था बट वेन वी गो फॉर द मल्टीपल आइटम्स so we can take the summation so sigma j is equal to 1 to n of all these these are the item costs jo item ki cost hogi wo hai this is the ordering cost our setup cost and this is the average carrying cost or holding cost okay ab jo maine aapse baat ki ke constraints to budgetary constraint ho sakta hai अब बजटरी कंस्ट्रेंट जो है इक्वेशन 3.2 में शो किया गया है ये क्या है सी जे क्यू जे क्या होगी क्यू वो क्वांटिटी होगी जो आप कैलकुलेट करते हैं क्यू राइट वो क्वांटिटी जो आप कैलकुलेट और जे क्या है क्योंकि मुख्तलिफ आइटम्स है तो मुख्तलिफ आइटम्स के लिए और फिर उनके यूनिट कॉस्ट होंगे सो उन सब को जब आप एड करेंगे कि कितनी क्वांटिटीज और फिर हर एक की यूनिट कॉस्ट ये है तो इतने के लिए क्या आपके पास बजट है भी कि नहीं सो दिस अमाउंट शुड बी लेस देन आर इक्वल टू बी बी इज द बजट राइट बी इज द मनी विच यू हैव सो दिस शुड बी लेस देन इक्वल टू बी अगर ये ज्यादा है बी से तो ज़ाहिर बात है आप तो अफोर्ड नहीं कर सकते फिर उसको सो दिस इज नाउ वन कंस्ट्रेंट एक कंस्ट्रेंट आ गया अदर कंस्ट्रेंट्स कैन ऑल्सो बी इम्पोज्ड ऑन द इन्वेंट्री The problem is formulated as minimize total cost, which is the summation of TC QJ, क्योंकि सबको आपने एड किया है and that is equal to sigma AJ DJ divided by QJ plus IJ CJ QJ divided by 2. इसमें से CJ DJ को हमने एक्सक्लूड कर दिया ताकि आसानी रहे क्योंकि उससे फर्क नहीं पड़ता वो तो आपको पे करना ही है तो उससे फर्क नहीं पड़ता है जिनको हम मिनिमाइज कर सकते हैं बेसिकली हम ऑर्डरिंग कॉस्ट और कैरिंग कॉस्ट को मिनिमाइज कर सकते हैं क्यों CJ QJ को आप मिनिमाइज नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि वो आपकी रिक्वायरमेंट है So that's why those two terms are excluded. That one term is excluded from here. Like in the previous, यहाँ पर given थी, हमने सिर्फ ये consider किए हैं, इसको निकाल दिए फिलहाल, चीज़ ये DJ को, क्योंकि इसको आप minimize नहीं कर सकते हैं, वो तो होगी. Okay, this total cost is subject to the constraint, and the constraint is CJ QJ should be less than equal to B, and QJ is obviously greater than equal to zero. Okay, if this is the situation, then we use the Lagrangian technique. Due to the non-linear nature of the equation, we use Lagrangian technique. Lekin Lagrangian technique aap us waqt use karenge when first we need to calculate the economic order quantities QJ star for every jo hai model ya every item, kyunki this is multiple item. So for every product we calculate QJ star, and that is the economic, using the economic order quantity model to AJ, DJ or ICJ. If CJ and QJ, kyunki QJ ko to aap calculate kar denge wahan se, if CJ times QJ is less than B, we don't use the Lagrangian technique because these are the optimal quantities. But if this constraint is violated, then we use the Lagrangian expression by introducing the Lagrangian multiplier. Wo kaise? Yahan pe likha hua hai. A check on feasibility is made by substituting QJ star into constraint 3.21. Isse pichli jo constraint thi, ye wali. Isme aap put kar dein. If the constraint is satisfied, the optimal ordering quantities are those obtained by this equation. Yahi aapki optimal quantities hai. Otherwise, the Lagrangian method is used. This is accomplished by developing a Lagrangian expression LE, which is given by Lagrangian expression ko humne kya kiya hai ke simply by adding the Lagrangian multiplier. Now, what is Lagrangian multiplier? Lambda. We call that lambda. So this is LE, Lagrangian expression of QJ, comma, lambda. This is equal to, ye to aapki wahi cost hai. Ye wali, jo abhi humne yahan pe di thi, ki humne isko minimize karna hai. Ye, so this jo hai expression plus lambda, which is the Lagrangian multiplier, वो मल्टीप्लायर है क्या? वो मल्टीप्लायर आएगा कहां से? दैट विल कम फ्रॉम द डिफरेंस ऑफ दीज टू, उसके जो आइटम्स की कॉस्ट होगी जो क्यूजे के साथ बनती है, माइनस आपकी जो वो है बजट है, उसको आप सब्ट्रैक्ट कर दें टू यू गेट एन अमाउंट. ओके, सो दैट इज प्लस लैम्डा इनटू दिस थिंग, वेयर लैम्डा इज द लैग्रेंजियन मल्टीप्लायर. अब बिकॉज वी हैव दिस इक्वेशन, अब ये लैम्डा जो है इसकी ऑप्टिमल वैल्यू क्या हो, क्यूजे की ऑप्टिमल वैल्यू क्या हो. सो ऑब्वियसली अगेन देयर इज मैथमेटिक्स इन्वॉल्व, यू नीड टू डिफरेंशिएट दिस इक्वेशन 3.31 फर्स्ट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू क्यूजे, मेकिंग द इक्वेशन इक्वल टू जीरो, एंड देन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू लैम्डा, अगेन मेकिंग द इक्वेशन इक्वल टू जीरो. सो वी विल गेट क्यूजे स्टार and lambda star. So once that is done, we it is written as QLJ, just to make it different from the other equations jo humne previously ki hain. We write this as QLJ star. QLJ star shows Q Lagrangian optimum. Lagrangian ke baad jo optimum quantity aapke paas hai, wo ye hai QLJ star. That is equal to square root of 2aj dj cj into 1 plus 2 lambda star. Lekin lambda star kis cheez ke equal hai? Lambda star ko jab aap isi equation ko differentiate karenge with respect to lambda, So you get lambda star equal to half of 1 over b sigma square root of 2 aj dj cj whole square minus I by 2. So यहां से हमारे आपके पास ऑप्टिमम क्वांटिटी और लैम्डा स्टार जो है आपके पास वो ऑप्टिमम जो मल्टीप्लायर उसकी वैल्यू आएगी. ओके, देन वी सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस इन दिस इक्वेशन, क्योंकि क्यू एल में अगर आप देख रहे हैं यहाँ पर लैम्डा स्टार लिखा हुआ है तो लैम्डा स्टार की वैल्यू यहां से आएगी. नाउ इफ वी सब्स्टिट्यूट लैम्डा स्टार देयर सो वी गेट क्यू एल जे स्टार, और उसको इन्होंने रीअरेंज किया है, बाद में इनको थोड़ा सा सिंप्लीफाई भी किया है. दैट इज रिटन एज बी ओवर सिग्मा सी जे क्यू जे स्टार टाइम्स क्यू जे स्टार इज इक्वल टू, इसको अगर हम ले लें कि जो क्यू जे स्टार है उसके बाद वाली सी जे क्यू जे स्टार, इसको अगर हम ई से शो कर दें ये बी हो, सो इट इज रिड्यूस टू बी ओवर ई टाइम्स क्यू जे स्टार, वेयर बी इज योर बजट and E is simply the quantities which you have calculated as optimum times their unit item costs. Unke sath aur sabko add kare so we get E, and it is shown here. Now let this the same thing has been explained with the help of this example. Aladdin's company produces electronic lamps rather than the usual magic lamps. मजाक किया है क्योंकि अलादीन के नाम से फौरन वो चिराग आपकी बात आ जाती है ज़हन में. So that's why I have written. Anyway, Aladdin's company produces electronic lamps. Three types of components are required for the production of the lamps. The management has an upper limit on the investment of 16,000. Upper limit on the investment. Now this is your budget. Our budgetary constraint, 16,000. The inventory carrying cost rate for each item is 0.18i, and shortages are not allowed. Data for each item are given in table 3.1. Data de diye unhone. Determine the optimum lot size for each item and the optimum cycle time. Okay. Demand. DJ, there are three items, so 1500, 1500, 2500 items. Yes, demand. There are three items. These are the item cost or unit cost. So $60, $30, $80. Setup cost, we gave them $60. Okay. दूसरे के लिए इन्होंने यहाँ पर I की वैल्यू दे दी है, तो यू कैन कैलकुलेट H एज वेल. H किसके बराबर है? H इज इक्वल टू आई सी. सो आई 0.18 है और C जो है हर एक की यहाँ पे मेंशन कर दी है. फर्स्ट वी कैलकुलेट वी यूज द इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी मॉडल. सो क्यू वन स्टार, बिकॉज दैट इज क्यू जे स्टार, इस इक्वेशन को आप यूज करें, ये वाली क्यू जे स्टार, दैट इज इक्वल टू square root of 2 aj dj divided by icj. So jab hum q1 use calculate karenge, so q1 star will be equal to 2 a1 d1 or ic1. ye values unhone de di already pichli table mein, is table mein ye aap values sare aapke paas maujood hain. So we calculate this as 129 units. Similarly calculate q2 star 183 units, Q3 star 144 units, and the inventory investment जो इससे निकलती है, जो इसकी inventory investment वो आपकी ये है, क्योंकि ये आपको फिर multiply करने पड़ेंगे उनके unit cost से. $60 टाइम इसका जो Q1 होगा, प्लस $30 टाइम इसका जो Q2 होगा, प्लस $80 टाइम इसका जो Q3 होगा, विच आर हियर. सो दिस इज 24,750. बजट क्या है आपके पास? बजट जो है वो 16,000 है, वो तो बता दिया यहां पे. इन्वेस्टमेंट के लिए अपर लिमिट जो है दैट इज 16,000. तो इसका मतलब है कि भाई ये तो इन क्वांटिटीज में तो आप नहीं कर सकते, आपको अपनी क्वांटिटीज कम करनी होंगी. जब आपकी क्वांटिटीज कम करनी होंगी रिमेंबर आप साल की ये डिमांड है ये मीट करेंगे, इस डिमांड को तो हम कम नहीं कर सकते, लेकिन जो हमारा लॉट साइज है हम इसको कम कर रहे हैं। जब हमारा लॉट साइज कम होगा तो आपको ज्यादा ऑर्डर्स प्लेस करने पड़ेंगे, सिर्फ ये होगा। लेकिन आपके पास उसके लिए जो है मतलब जो क्वांटिटीज आपकी रिड्यूस होंगी, तो ऑब्वियसली इफ इट इज अंडर द आर विद इन द लिमिट ऑफ द बजट देन यू कैन प्लेस द ऑर्डर्स। बट प्रेजेंटली 24,750 it is more than your allowable budget. अब हमें Lagrangian technique जो है वो use करनी होगी। For the Lagrangian technique, उसको जो simplify किया गया वो क्या था? That was equal to B over E times QJ. ये था QLJ star. That was B over E times QJ star. बी क्या है? बजट है। ई आपने कैलकुलेट करना है, और अभी हमने कैलकुलेट बल्कि कर भी लिया है। हमारे पास जो 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 इसकी जो कॉस्ट आ रही है वो आ रही है 24,750। तो हम पहली क्वांटिटी कैलकुलेट करेंगे यूजिंग द लैग्रेंजियन QL1 स्टार, दैट विल बी 16,000 ईयरली डिवाइडेड बाय 24,750 Q1 अभी जो आपने कैलकुलेट किया था using the economic order quantity model. So this is reduced to 83 units. QL2 is 118 units. QL3 aapka aa jata hai 93 units. Previously kya the? Previously ye jo units the ye the 83 units QL1 tha, sorry ye 129 units Q1 tha, 183 यूनिट्स Q2 था, 144 यूनिट्स Q3 था, और इसकी जो टोटल कॉस्ट आनी थी वो हमारे बजट से ज्यादा थी। तो हमने इन क्वांटिटीज को रिड्यूस किया, कैसे? यूजिंग दी लैग्रेंजियन टेक्निक, और उससे ये रिड्यूस हो गए 83 यूनिट्स को, 118 यूनिट्स को एंड 93 यूनिट्स को। अब इसकी हम अगर यूनिट कॉस्ट चेक करें, इसकी कॉस्ट चेक करें जिस तरह ये था, तो इसकी कॉस्ट चेक करते हैं, which is not shown here, but anyway you can now calculate 83 units times iski jo unit cost hai, unit cost kya hai iski, unit cost iski $60 hai, plus jo next plus $30 dusre ki unit cost hai, lekin iski ab jo quantity hai wo hai 118 units, iski jo jo wo cost hai ye $80 hai, C3, और इसकी इंस्टेड ऑफ 144 नाउ वी हैव 93 यूनिट्स। तो इसको आप चेक कर लें, इट विल डेफिनेटली बी लेस देन 16,000, या इक्वल होगा या इससे कम होगा, लेकिन वायलेट नहीं करेगा। तो हमने इनको जो है बेसिकली वो क्वांटिटीज को हमने ठीक कर दिया। ओके, देन अनदर एग्जांपल, I leave this example to you because it is about this floor space. It is about the floor space. कि अगर आपके पास floor space जो है उसकी मतलब constraint हो, तो फिर आप इसको कैसे deal करेंगे? Example already solved है. There's another example. Okay, so I leave these two examples to you. Now let's go through continuous review. एक तो हमारे पास एक ये ऐसे मॉडल्स हैं कि जो कि नॉर्मली यूज होते हैं। continuous review का मतलब ये है कि आप जो है अपने मॉडल्स को लगातार रिव्यू करते जा रहे हैं, और जो continuous review है उसका उसमें जो है डिमांड जो है वो बेसिकली प्रिडिक्टेबल है। continuous review में डिमांड इज प्रिडिक्टेबल एंड let me explain it first. Okay, we have the on-hand inventory on this side, and on obviously on the x-axis we have time. This is the order which is received, or the inventory which you can keep. Once it is depleted, ye deplete ho rahi hai, depletion R use. So when it reaches to the reorder level, R is the reorder level. When it reaches to R, the an order is placed, and by the time we you see the lead time starts from here. By the time when we use the inventory, it is replenished because it is the sorry the arrival the inventory arrives and then it is replenished. But you see, it is replenished straight upward. It is a variant of the economic order quantity model. So the in the continuous review, basically, we review the inventory frequently, even on daily basis, because the computers are nowadays available, and whenever there is a withdrawal from the stock, if you remember, when you go to the shopping mall and you do some shopping at the jahan par aap pay kar rahe hote hain, matlab wahan pe, so the person who he basically scans the items, and there's a barcode on the items, ya jo box hai ya packet hai jo us pe bhi hai. That box shows two things. One is the price of the inventory, the price of the item, and the other thing is the inventory status. Because when that is scanned, it straight away goes to the it is linked with the inventory as well, and it shows that an item has gone out from the stock, and so much is now. So many items are left in the on the shelves, so that also shows the status of the inventory. Now, when it is, frequently reviewed, so we call it basically the continuous review. And accordingly, you know that when your inventory level or your inventory stock reaches to a certain level, then you replenish the inventory. हर बातें वहां से आपको पता चलता है कि आपके स्टॉक में इतनी इतनी इन्वेंट्री रह गई है, एंड दिस रीऑर्डर इज बेसिकली दिस ऑर्डर लेवल इज बेसिकली कैलकुलेटेड. ओके, सो दिस इज वन मॉडल, एंड दिस इज टाइम बिटवीन ऑर्डर्स, टीबीओ टीबीओ, एंड इट गोज ऑन लाइक दिस सेम थिंग. सो जितनी आप जब आप यूज करते हैं, तो आप जाहिर बात है कि वही फिक्स्ड क्वांटिटी जो है आपकी, जितनी आपने कैलकुलेट की हुई है, वो आप ऑर्डर करते हैं और आपकी इन्वेंट्री जो है वो फिर रिप्लेनिश हो जाती है. सो इट गोज ऑन लाइक दिस. दिस इज कंटिन्यूअस रिव्यू. इट इज फॉलोड बाय एन एग्जांपल. डिमांड फॉर चिकन सूप एट अ सुपरमार्केट इज ऑलवेज 25 केसेस अ डे एंड द लीड टाइम इज ऑलवेज 4 डेज. मतलब ये सर्टन है, इज ऑलवेज, कहते डिमांड जो है चिकन सूप के लिए वो ऑलवेज है 25 केसेस. सो इट मींस इट्स अ सर्टेन डिमांड एंड द लीड टाइम इज आल्सो सर्टेन आर नोन एंड द लीड टाइम इज ऑलवेज 4 डेज. द शेल्व्स वर जस्ट रीस्टॉक्ड विद चिकन सूप लीविंग एन ऑन हैंड इन्वेंटरी ऑफ ओनली 10 केसेस. नो बेक ऑर्डर्स करंटली एग्जिस्ट बट देयर इज वन ओपन ऑर्डर in the pipeline for 200 cases. Remember open order, ye lafz jo hai open order ko hum bazookat scheduled receipt kehte hain. Scheduled receipt, and scheduled receipt is basically inventory for which you have issued an order, but the inventory has not yet arrived, and you expect that this inventory is going to be received in a certain time period. So open order or schedule receipt, same thing. In the pipeline for 200 cases, matlab ye hai ki 200 cases jo hain aapke wo aane wale hain. What is the inventory position? Should a new order be placed? Kehte hain naya order place kar de ki nahi, aapki inventory position kya hai? Inke paas jo filhal inventory hai wo kuch yun hai. कि ये जो इनका पैटर्न है कि 25 केसेस जो है पर डे यूज होते हैं, और उसका लीड टाइम जो चार दिन है. द शेल्स वर स्टॉक्ड विद द चिकन सूप लीविंग ऑन हैंड, आपके पास ऑन हैंड इन्वेंट्री जो है वो 10 केसेस हैं. तो ये हमें तब पता चलेगा कि हमारा रीऑर्डर लेवल है क्या. ओके, लेट्स गो थ्रू इट. द सेम दिस सेम मॉडल विच इज यूज्ड. ओके, रीऑर्डर आपका जो है वो ये है, एवरेज डिमांड ड्यूरिंग लीड टाइम वो क्या है, 25 केसेस और उसका जो 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 लीड टाइम है दैट इज बेसिकली 4. इट्स रीऑर्डर को कैसे कैलकुलेट करते हैं, दैट इज इक्वल टू डी एल. डी क्या है? डिमांड. एल आपका लीड टाइम. सो 25 into 4, that is 100 cases. आपका जो ये reorder level है, आपने set किया है, ये आप 100 cases पर set करेंगे. अब आपके पास inventory position क्या है? IP. IP inventory position. This is equal to on hand inventory plus जो उन्होंने कहा था open order. Open order is basically SR. SR क्या है? Scheduled receipt. Scheduled receipt minus back order. अगर कोई बैक ऑर्डर है तो वो भी आप घर बातें फुलफिल करेंगे. सो दैट इज यूजुअली सबट्रैक्टेड. बैक ऑर्डर क्या होते हैं? जब शॉर्टेजेस हो. ओके, इस वक्त जो इन्वेंट्री पोजीशन है दैट इज इक्वल टू ऑन हैंड 10 केसेस. अभी बताया था उन्होंने कि देयर आर 10 केसेस ऑन हैंड. सो ऑन हैंड 10 केसेस. ओपन ऑर्डर जो है व्हिच आर द एसआर व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी रिसीव्ड दैट इज 200 minus 0 because there is no back order. So 200 cases. आपके पास inventory position जो है वो 200 cases है. आपका reorder level जो है वो 100 है. Although इसके उन्होंने कहा था कि यहाँ पर थोड़ा पीछे जाएं. ये what is the inventory position? So inventory position is 210 cases. Should a new order be placed? कहते हैं कि नया order place कर दें. I think no. वो इसलिए no. Although we have exhausted the on hand. On hand क्या है? 10 है. तकरीबन exhaust हो चुका है. आपका reorder level जो है वो set है 100 cases पर. But these 200 cases are on way and they are going to be received, right? So still you will have 210 cases. It means you don't need to place an order. We will place an order when it reaches to the reorder level. Ya isse kam ho jayega. Agar isse kam hote to phir wo ek aur situation banti hai. Wo uncertain demand mein banti hai. Uncertain demand. Uncertain demand kya hai? K, you see, order received, ye uski depletion ho rahi hai. Right? Here we have set the reorder level. Right, reorder level, then we, by the time, considering the lead time, then we basically place the order, it goes to the supplier or it is produced and then our inventory is replenished and it goes on like this. But here you see, these time between orders is now not fixed. Time between orders is now not fixed because of uncertainty. Or yeah, aap is graph ko bhi dekh lein yahan par, yahan tak aaya hai, niche zyada aa gaya hai aise. So it's due to uncertain demand. Okay, how to deal with the uncertain demand? When we have the uncertain demand, then in addition to calculating inventory aapki jo hai safety stock hai, we consider the safety stock as well. In the uncertain situation we consider the safety stock. Aur usme kaise safety stock ko hum kaise consider karte hain? Reorder point usko calculate karne ke liye, because it's due to the uncertainty we calculate the reorder point as this is the basically the average demand during the lead time, average demand during the lead time, and this is our cycle service level. For example, our cycle service level is 85%. If our cycle service level is 85%, it means 85% of the time we satisfy, and 15% there are chances that there will be stock out or shortages. 15%. So probability of stock out kya hai? 1 minus 0.15. Ab agar ye probability hai, तो हम जो है अपना सेफ्टी स्टॉक वगैरह ये कैसे कैलकुलेट करें और हमारी इन्वेंट्री पोजीशन पे इसका क्या फर्क पड़ता है. लेट अस रिटर्न टू द बर्ड फीडर इन एग्जांपल 12.2 द इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी इज 75 यूनिट्स. आई एम सॉरी यू हैव नॉट गॉन थ्रू दिस एग्जांपल 12.2 बट एनीवे द इकोनॉमिक ऑर्डर क्वांटिटी इज 75 यूनिट्स. Suppose that the average demand is 18 units per week with a standard deviation of 5 units. The lead time is constant at 2 weeks. Determine the safety stock and reorder point if management wants a 90% service level. Although I have not gone through this example because this is from another book, which is by Krojewski. But since it was related to this uncertainty and safety stock, so that's why I just picked it up. Lead time for the bird feeder, because it's the time periods are in weeks, so that time T is taken as week. This is the go back. Average demand. Suppose that the average demand is 18 weeks per week. So T is, the time periods are in weeks. So T is week, basically 1 week. And the D is 18 units per week. And the standard deviation is 5 units. Lead time is 2 weeks. Average demand is 18. So from there we can calculate a sigma L, which is equal to sigma T of square root of L equal to 7.1. And safety stock in fact is equal to, because the things are uncertain, so the safety stock is equal to Z sigma L. Now Z sigma jo hai, Z is basically the value of Z taken from the Z tables, area under the normal curve jo hai, agar aapko yaad ho padhte hain iske. So this 1.28 is taken, why? Because for 90% service level, if you open the book, any book on the statistic, you will see for 90% service level, the closest value, if it is exactly 0.900, that will be ideal. But any value which is close to that, you will pick that value and then check the Z value for that. So the Z value associated with that is 1.28 times this sigma L. This is 9.1 or 9 units. So the in order to calculate the reorder point, it is equal to DL, your average demand, times the lead time plus safety stock. So 2 is the lead time, D average demand is the 18, safety stock we have just calculated, so it is 45 units. The thing obviously this example is you have not gone through this example 2.2, but the point I wanted to explain was that when we have uncertainty in demand, so our reorder level, it goes up by an amount which is equal to the safety stock. Agar aap yahan par dekh le, yahan par koi isme safety stock ka koi zikr nahi hai, right? No mention, kyunki we have calculated the reorder level, and the reorder level is simply the average demand during the lead time. Every demand during the lead time, there is 20, according to this example, it was 25 into 4, so we set it at 100 yahan par. But when we have the uncertain demand, then along with this R, we add safety stock, and then we set this R at certain point R. Or us safety stock ko calculate karne ke liye, because the things are uncertain, for when we keep the safety stock, it means you are providing certain service level, service to the customers, whether that service is 80%, 90% or 100%. Of course 100% is very, very difficult. Sometimes So when the service level is not 100%, it means there is a probability of stock out. And according to this 90% service level, because it was shown 90% service level, according to 90% service level, and according to the data over here, our re-order point is set at 45 units. But remember, it is a different example. Previously, just by 100 cases, that was different. It is a different example. So the re-order point is set as your DL, which is average demand during the lead time, plus safety stock. And that's it. Any question? Are you with me?
Yes, sir. Sir, आपने जो वैसे तो इसके हवाले से कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं है, लेकिन जो प्रीवियस वीडियोस आपने शेयर की है ना सर, उसमें वॉइस प्ले नहीं हो रही है।
मुझे उसका तो मुझे पता नहीं है कि क्योंकि मैं तो कोशिश करता हूँ कि बिल्कुल लैपटॉप और स्क्रीन के बिल्कुल करीब से बोलूं, तो अगर कोई वॉइस का इश्यू है तो आई कांट से एनीथिंग। रिकॉर्डिंग चीजें तो होती नहीं है, अगर लैपटॉप आवाज को मेरी पिक कर रहा है तो बस यही है, क्योंकि आई डोंट रिकॉर्ड इन एडवांस, मैं एडवांस में कभी रिकॉर्ड नहीं करता, मैं डायरेक्टली लेक्चर डिलीवर करता हूँ और उसमें कोई एडिटिंग भी नहीं करता, अनएडिटेड इसलिए पेश करता हूँ ताकि आपको हर एक चीज जो है वो सामने हो।
एक्सक्यूज मी
बेटा, आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही।
सर ये मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि अगर सर आप इश्तियाक साहब से कहे कि जितने लेक्चर हुए अभी तक तो उनके स्लाइड्स अगर हमारे साथ शेयर कर ले तो बहुत अच्छा होगा। पिछली बार भी सर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग जो सिस्टम की जो पेपर थी वो भी जस्ट वन वीक पहले उन लोगों ने शेयर की।
मुझे तो इश्तियाक ने बताया वो शेयर कर लिए हैं, आई थिंक आपने
वो रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर शेयर की है, स्लाइड शेयर नहीं किए।
सर स्लाइड शेयर हो गई है, वी हैव चेक्ड,
स्लाइड शेयर हो जाते हैं ना, क्योंकि जो हम जो अभी बोल रहे हैं इवन दिस इज बीइंग रिकॉर्डेड, जो अभी हम बातचीत कर रहे हैं रिकॉर्ड हो रहा है, तो आपके पास तो हर एक चीज आ रही है, क्योंकि इसमें जो हम रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर है उसमें स्लाइड्स भी उसी के बीच में है ना।
ओके सर मैं देखता हूँ,
आप चेक कर लें। अच्छा इसको तो ये कंप्लीट पैकेज है। ओके अभी मैंने इसको स्टॉप किया शेयरिंग को, तो एनी क्वेश्चन, इफ नॉट ओके देन वी विल सी इंशाल्लाह नेक्स्ट वीक, इज इट ओके?
सर ये चैप्टर के कौन से बुक से लिया गया?
ये उसमें है एनालिसिस एंड कंट्रोल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम्स बाय अल सैयद एंड बाउचर।
यस
ये जो है बुक शायद आई डोंट थिंक के लाइब्रेरी में होगी, लेकिन जो जो स्लाइड्स हैं उसमें इसका डिटेल्स मैंने बता भी दिया है, क्योंकि वो स्लाइड्स मैंने स्कैन करके इसके वो इक्वेशंस उसी तरह डाल दिए हैं।
ओके सर
ठीक है, इंशाल्लाह नेक्स्ट वीक वी विल स्टार्ट विद द एमआरपी। तो काइंडली अपने बाकी स्टूडेंट्स जो दोस्त हैं उनसे कहें कि लेक्चर को मिस ना करें, स्लाइड्स से आप आई डोंट नो कि आप कितना इसको पिक करेंगे जब आप खुद बैठेंगे, लेकिन अगर आप प्रेजेंट हो तो आप क्वेश्चन भी पूछ सकते हैं, और ये बहुत जरूरी किस्म की चीजें होती हैं जो कि बाद में आपके फ्यूचर में बहुत काम आती हैं। ओके
बुक हमें तोहफा में मिल जाएगी सर?
ये बुक तो मेरे पास ही है, एक अभी मैंने टेबल पे पड़ी है, अगर इसमें से कोई इसको फोटो कॉपी करना चाहे मतलब पूरी बुक को तो आई डोंट नो कि उसको कितना। जी बोले, हेलो
सर ये नाम हमें बताएं सर, हम नेट से डाउनलोड करेंगे सर।
अच्छा ये है एनालिसिस एंड कंट्रोल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम्स।
यस सर,
और बाय अल सैयद, अल सैयद जो है
E L
S A Y E D अल सैयद। ठीक है, एंड एंड बाउचर, बाउचर बी ओ यू
सर
सी एच ई आर,
ओके सर, थैंक यू सर।
हाँ तो ये आप उस आप मतलब
कौन सा एडिशन है?
The one which I have, it is second edition. I don't think it is in print anymore. Lekin it's a classic book on the production systems.
Okay.
Okay. So, okay, inshallah, see you next week. Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz, sir.
Allah Hafiz.